Hello and welcome to Starting Points. I am your host, Jay Brenneman, bringing to you the voices of change in your communities and our region. Joining me today is Chris Arkwright, Vice President of Young Erie Professionals. Chris, thank you for being here today.
Jay, thank you for having me.
So before we get into Young Erie Professionals, your day job, you work for Habitat for Humanity, operating the ReStore. Could you tell me a little bit more about the mission and work of Habitat for Humanity in Erie County, and then tell me a little bit more about the ReStore?
Sure. So Habitat for Humanity in Erie has actually been around for 25 years. In fact, we're going to be doing our 25th anniversary house celebration.
What does that mean? A celebration. What would that involve?
Well, it's actually the celebration house is the house that is commemorating the 25th anniversary.
So that's the name, because all the houses have names.
Yes. Okay. Yeah. So I mean, there are faith builds, which there love and faith and things of that nature over the past years, but there are three houses being built this year. And the first one being the 25th anniversary house.
Is it usually three houses or two houses a year? Is there any?
On average, there's about three.
Okay.
Yep. To this date, there I believe are about 60 or so around there that have been built through Habitat in
That's
Erie.
Amazing. Yeah. Are they just in the city of Erie, or are they around the county?
Most of them are in Erie County. Or in the city of Erie. Mm-hmm. I believe there are a few in Union City.
And what are the qualifiers that, for people for Habitat for a house? Do you know some of the basic ones you could share with us?
Well, I mean, I do know that there is a specific need that has to be presented, and they do budget coaching and all of that stuff. I mean, the houses are not free. Mm-hmm. There's a lot of time and effort and sweat equity hours that have to be put in.
So sweat equity, that means they have to help build other houses.
Right.
And
they don't,
their own.
Right. So they actually spend time in the program helping to build other people's homes. So they do that first before there's even a talk of their home. So they have to spend time helping other people before they can move forward through the program. But financially, it's a loan, essentially a 0% interest loan. They still have to pay on and all of that. But as far as the ReStore, the ReStore plays into that because all of the proceeds from the store go directly into helping Habitat continue its mission of providing homes, community, and hope for families in our area.
And the ReStore is a little bit of a play on words, right? Because it
right.
is a store.
Yeah, so it is. There are a few aspects that play into that. So, you hear the phrase reduce, recycle,
reuse.
Yeah, so the ReStore is essentially that. It's a retail space owned and operated by Habitat for Humanity. It runs completely on donation. It was established here in 2007. There are several other resources throughout the country. You know, we have a lot of people that actually come to the store and say, "Oh, well, I was at the ReStore here, the ReStore there." You know, they love it. You know, or a lot of people recently. People that have moved to Erie coming in, you know, because they knew about the ReStore in other places, so they came to check out the ReStore here. But, all the proceeds go directly to helping Habitat continue its mission.
And what kind of items does the ReStore sell?
Yeah, so all the items are either new or used in good condition, and it's really anything that goes into a home. So whether it's building materials are one of our main focuses, but everything from plates and dishes to hinges, any hardware, anything that goes into a home, with the exceptions, which would be upholstered items, so no couches or love seats, things of that nature.
Like doors, windows, sinks.
You name it. If it goes into a home, we typically carry it.
But since they're based on donations, I guess it's almost like a surprise.
Right.
Keeps it interesting.
Right, exactly. I really except for maybe the week before, I don't have any idea of what's going to be available for sale. So it's always interesting trying to reset the store, trying to find figure out ways how we're going to lay things out. Mm-hmm. It's exciting, but also a little challenging. At
the pricing time. Prices are good, right?
Yes, and that's probably one of the big draws. I mean, aside from the fact that you're helping Habitat, mm-hmm. you're able to get things at a considerably lower price than what you would anywhere else. For example, an interior door, our base price is $10.95.
That's extremely cheap.
Yeah. Right. I mean, other places...
10 times that at least.
Right, you're looking at least $100.
So, and you said you don't know a week before, so what are the hours and the days that the restore's open?
Yeah, so the restore's open on Saturdays from 8 to 4. Mm-hmm. That's open to the general public, so that's only one day a week. Mm-hmm. But we're open for donations Tuesday through Friday from 10 a.m. to 2 p.m.
So if somebody has, if they're doing a remodel or if they have, they bought some housing or they're trying to sell some or get rid of some of their items in their home, they can mm-hmm. donate that.
Right.
As a donation, as a charitable donation.
Right. So we provide a receipt. We don't put assign a specific cost to mm-hmm. those items, but you receive an itemized receipt with everything that you donate, and you know you have to work that out with your own accountant to determine what the value of those things were.
Well, that's excellent. So, how can our viewers learn more about the restore? Is there a website, a Facebook page?
Yes, we have social media and a website. So the website is www.habitaterie.org/restore.
Okay.
So pretty simple. And then the social media is just Habitat Erie on Facebook and on Twitter.
So open again Saturdays, you said 8 to 4?
Yes.
And it's located in the city of Erie?
Yes. It's at 903 Parade Street.
903 Parade Street.
And the donation location is just around the corner at 413 East 9th.
That's great. Well, thank you for telling us about that.
Absolutely.
Kind of segue or make a quite a bit of a gear change here. Mm-hmm. You're also volunteer as a vice president for mm-hmm. Young Erie Professionals.
Yes.
Tell me a little bit more about your role, and then we'll get into the Young Erie Professionals.
Sure. Thank you. So there are actually currently three vice presidents. I just wanted to clarify. Mm-hmm. I don't want anyone to think that I'm the vice president. But so there are three vice presidents. Myself, I am actually the VP of Community Involvement and Marketing.
Okay, so Community Involvement and Marketing, what does that mean?
Well, Community Involvement, really my goal with that is to develop a team that focuses on being the eyes and ears of the community, especially the nonprofit community. You know, we have quite a few, I think mm-hmm. 280 or 300 nonprofits in Erie. And kind of just be the eyes and ears of those organizations so that when there are volunteer opportunities or things that we feel would be beneficial for our members and mm-hmm. as well as the community to be involved with, we present those opportunities to members.
So what is Young Erie Professionals? What is its mission?
Well, our mission is pretty simple. On the website it has all kinds of stuff about a mission statement, all of that. But really, it's a group of people, young professionals that are engaged with our community, that care, that have decided to stay here for one reason or another, and that want to see Erie thrive and succeed. And so we put together events. We foster a sense of community for young professionals, a reason for them to stick around. Everyone talks about brain drain, and it's something that you see articles on mm-hmm. quite often. Brain drain this, brain drain that. Well, what we would like to do is to put together, a community of young professionals that say yes, I'm here, I want to help make a difference. What can we do? how can we do it?
So is there a definition of young?
Currently, I believe the definition as it stands is anyone under 40.
Okay.
So.
Well, I think that's both of us, right?
Yes, yes.
So the term professionals, is that just, is there a certain degree requirement, or is that just, what is that?
Well, I think that really just depends on, you know, how you carry yourself.
Okay.
You know, and
so you care about, you know, your community, you care about your career, et cetera.
Right. We have never, at least to my knowledge, have ever turned anyone away based on the fact that they don't have a college degree or they work at a particular place.
Now, is there a physical location for Young Area Professionals, or is this a group?
Well, there's a mailing address,
okay.
But we don't meet at those offices. Yeah. All of our meetings are held at different locations throughout.
What are those meetings like?
Yeah. Well, we have a steering committee, and then from the steering committee, we also have subcommittees. So, steering committee gets together, you know, once a month, on general circumstances, and kind of decides what we're going to do and where we're going to go. Then we have the subcommittees that plan events and that handle, you know, specific things. Like I have a marketing subcommittee. I am working on building a community involvement committee.
What kind of, do you know, just broadly, what type of walks of life, what kind of background does some of the members or some of the committee members have?
Right. So we have people that are doctors. We have people that are going to school. We have people that that are in military or you know, in part-time military, reserve, things of that nature. We have people that work in retail. It doesn't matter.
That's a pretty diverse.
Right, right. Crowd. And one of the things that we're actually doing right now, which is something I'm pretty excited about, we've been working on this, and we're rolling out a pilot program for one of the local universities to offer a free one-year membership to students that are graduating. And that's something that I think is going to be successful. We just started rolling that out, and once we kind of figure out how all that's going to work and what are the strengths and weaknesses, all that stuff, then we're going to hopefully roll it out to other.
So there's a lot of giving back.
Yes.
Well, let's hold that thought, Chris.
Okay.
I believe we have a break that we'll be going to. We will be right back after this break with Chris Arkwright, the Vice President for Young Erie Professionals.
When you throw away money on wasted electricity, you're throwing away everything you could have bought with it. Saving energy saves you money. Learn more at energysavers.gov. The average text takes your eyes off the road for nearly 5 seconds.
Listen, I know you're upset, but it was just one date. And dating's like the stock market. There's ups and downs and ups and so always buy low.
You don't have to be perfect to be a perfect parent. There are thousands of teens in foster care who would love to put up with you.
NFC, AFC, offensive linemen, defensive tackles, quarterbacks, and cornerbacks are all living united to ensure the academic success of millions of kids in our communities all the way to graduation day. But that won't happen without you. So take the pledge at unitedway.org. Make a difference in the life of a child. Suit up like your favorite NFL players and become a volunteer reader, tutor, or mentor with United Way.
Hello and welcome back to Starting Points. We're back here with Chris Arkwright. And before the break, we were talking about some of the work that Young Erie Professionals is doing. Mm-hmm. And one of those things was a scholarship that you're pursuing with one of the local universities. But is there a purpose behind Young Erie Professionals towards the professional development of its members? Could you tell me a little bit more about that?
So we actually have a VP of professional development. His name is Devin Baker. And he's in charge of putting together programs, seminars, or you know, any kind of event to help train our young professionals and our members, and provide information that will be helpful to them in their careers.
What might that look like?
Okay, so most recently we actually had, and it's a simple thing, but we actually had a LinkedIn, 101. course. Mm-hmm. So we had Leslie Ridge come in, and she did a presentation and talked about pointers and tips and things of that nature for our members. And it was free to our members. Mm-hmm. We have a lot of events that are free to our members, similar to that. It helps. I know that a lot of people from our generation are very tech savvy and, mm-hmm. and things of that nature, but there are people that are not, and we had a whole range of people there
to refine your
right.
If you think
right.
you're
and,
good,
and also, I mean, my hope is to continue doing something like that on a regular basis, mm-hmm. and then also to provide something on a higher level, like an intermediate or more in-depth course.
So depending on where you might be at or what you might have done,
right.
You can advance and get a little bit more out of it.
Yes.
So the meeting is kind of going back to that.
Mm-hmm.
Now there's the meetings that the committees have.
Right.
And those are very business oriented, mm-hmm. which they would have to be.
Yeah, and we have an hour and a half. We have a lot to go over. So
tell me a little bit of the benefits of, or should I say, the value of participating in some leadership with Young Erie Professionals or being involved in that way. Tell me some of the what you get out of it or what you think others would get out of it.
Yeah. Well, personally, I really enjoy working with everyone on the team. I like to work in groups. I like to accomplish tasks. I like to really put something together that, after it's complete, I can go, wow, look what we did, and it's a team effort.
Mm-hmm.
Some of the stuff that we do that's beneficial for our members as far as what do they get out of joining member becoming a member and joining Young Erie Professionals. I would say number one is network. You develop a network not only within Young Erie Professionals, but also when you're helping to plan events, you're making calls to local businesses and companies and mm-hmm. nonprofits. You're trying to make things work, not only as acting as an ambassador for Young Erie Professionals, mm-hmm. but also you personally make those connections, whether it's and one great thing is, if I may real quick,
mm-hmm.
with the rollout that we're doing for colleges and universities, the pilot program that I was talking about earlier, we want to provide a community that will help retain students after they graduate, hopefully find a job. And this could be a good avenue to do that because they get to meet with people mm-hmm. that are currently serving in positions at companies that they might want to work for or working in fields that they are aspiring to work in. We're also working on a mentoring program through the board. So things of that nature, mm-hmm. Yes, we're doing the professional development. Yes, we have our networking events, which we probably should talk about next. But we have all kinds of things that we're doing. But as far as benefiting individually, I think the connections that people make in combination with the life skills that they get from helping to plan these events.
So the importance of networking. I mean, why would somebody want to say to join the organization? Is it something you should wait till you graduate? You said there's some students. So is it mm-hmm. something you should wait till you graduate and then you start thinking about that?
No, and that's
why
the reason.
Not?
That's okay. So that's the reason we sat down and said, hey, we have a good group of people. What can we do that's going to be, not only benefit young area professionals to bring people in, bring talent in, but also provide something for students that might otherwise look elsewhere to get a job, leave Erie. So we said, well, let's look at how can we reach these students that are seniors mm-hmm. that for all of the reasons might just graduate, go back home or whatever. Maybe they'll decide to get a job here and stay. So we decided to roll something out to the local universities, and again, it's a pilot program. Mm-hmm. We're doing it with one university here in
Arizona. So I was incorrect when I used the term scholarship.
Yes.
Okay.
But no problem. So the program again provides a 1 year junior membership, that allows them to attend all of the free mm-hmm. YEP events, professional development, the networking events that we host every month, at various locations around Erie. A lot of times we showcase things that like new businesses or new restaurants that are opening here and here, and we've got a lot of them.
Mm-hmm.
There's quite a few new things
right.
going on downtown, which is great.
So the importance of networking, but what's the importance of networking amongst your peers versus the value of that versus just going out there and trying to network with business owners or somebody from a different generation that might be.
Well, I mean, I guess. There is a certain level of networking that is done between members, between peers, but also, I mean, a lot of our members come from different states, different backgrounds, but we actually, a lot of them have become very good friends.
Mm-hmm.
So it's not necessarily we are professional, we are looking to grow Young Erie professionals. We're looking to network. We're looking to provide opportunities for young people in Erie, but also we are friends.
Mm.
I don't want it to come across as that it's all rigid and
right.
and things of that nature.
So some of that you get the social aspect of it.
Right.
So particularly, let's say if you're a student that you go to one of the local universities or your family moves into town mm-hmm. or in the area, and it gives you an opportunity to meet your peers and usually in a relaxed atmosphere. A lot of these get-togethers, these meetings that are done, the socials or some of the learning experiences, they're a little bit more relaxed.
Yeah, I mean, one of our really nice, we now call them networking events. We decided that even though it is a member-based organization, mm-hmm. and it is kind of a social engagement, We also want to, you know, maintain the professional status of that. So we're calling them networking events. But one of the really great ones we had recently was at 1201.
So that's a restaurant in Erie.
Yes. Yeah, 1201
a,
Kitchen.
A good restaurant, right?
Yes. Yeah. In my opinion, one of the best, if not the best. My favorite. I like to go there for ramen, for lunch. But
I think a lot of people our age, particularly if you're a college student, you're going to enjoy some good ramen, right?
Yes. Yes. And not to plug them too much.
Oh, sure. They're not sponsoring this.
No.
Maybe they should. Maybe we should get some free ramen out of this.
Maybe I'll have to go up there. They make all their ramen. Everything's homemade. You know,
so you had this event, and everybody come to. And why was it successful? Was it because of the food, the atmosphere, or
all of it? You know, people know 1201 for the most part. Mm-hmm. They have awesome sushi.
So these events, they travel around to,
yes.
Are they always at a restaurant or are they at other venues?
Most of them are at restaurants, places that serve food and alcohol.
Mm-hmm.
We have one coming up in April, I believe it's at 28 North.
So it's an opportunity also for the members to check out some of the restaurant scene, the food scene.
Right, and like when Gelati's opened, we had one
there.
So
kind of going around and traveling around and getting some of that. Tell me a little bit about, you spoke about at least if you're active in a leadership role with younger ear professionals, that you get to interact with some of the local organizations or businesses or practicing professionals in the region. But for a everyday member, what is their exposure to some of these businesses or nonprofits or some of these other organizations?
Well, there's no minimum engagement. You know, the fee to join is relatively low.
Mm-hmm.
It's $30 or $50 for an executive membership. So we don't have minimum requirements as far as what people have to do.
Mm-hmm.
So they can determine what their level of involvement is. As far as what they do beyond that is up to them. And we actually have a lot of volunteer opportunities. That's one of the main ways that our members.
So they volunteer for a charitable cause.
Yes,
they get to know a little bit more about the issue, the organization that
mm-hmm.
they're supporting. At the same time, networking with some of the those that are in that realm or in that field. So, Chris, real quick,
mm-hmm.
if somebody wants to know a little bit more about Young Erie Professionals, there's several different ways to find out, right? Other than coming and talking with you. But tell me a little bit more about how we can find out for our viewers.
Well, I think the easiest thing to do would be to visit the website. So that would be yeperie.org.
Is that a common abbreviation? Is that so instead of saying Young Erie Professional, just
yes.
say I'm a member of YEP or come be a part of YEP?
Yeah, I mean, I think that in the past it's been widely referred to as YEP, and internally, rather than when we're talking to each other, we say YEP, because it's understood. But when I'm talking mm-hmm. to people that have never heard of it before, mm-hmm. I say Young Erie Professionals.
So if they hear YEP or Young Erie Professionals,
mm-hmm.
same thing.
Yes.
You gave us the web address. How else could somebody learn about?
Well, obviously we have social media, we have all of our events that are upcoming. Listed on our Facebook page, that would be facebook.com/YEPErie.
So let's say they want to get a taste of it. They can they show up before committing to a membership to one of these meetings or one of these networking events?
Yes, absolutely. Again, most of our events are free for members.
Mm-hmm.
Some of them have a nominal fee. Others are free for members and a nominal fee for non-members.
For guests,
but so we try to work it out so that the price of membership
mm-hmm.
is easily compensated
oh, sure.
for over the course of, you know, if you attend mm-hmm. so many events, it's, you know, it easily pays for itself.
Well, Chris, thank you so much for being here today.
Thank you.
Learned
for
quite
me.
A bit. Look forward to seeing some more of the great work that Young Ear Professionals and the Restore is doing. Thank you for joining us for this edition of Starting Points. Tune in again next time.